Hi guys, today we are going to look at garbage collection, references counting or reference counting, whatever you can, if you wish you can put that, used in garbage collectors. First we let us understand what is garbage collection, why it is important, then let us move on to references counting, garbage collectors or the comparative study of different languages, programming languages I mean to say. Memory or object allocation and deallocation is termed as garbage collection. It can be done manually or automatically. What is the meaning of memory allocation and deallocation? First, let us understand. Garbage means what? The moment it is useless, garbage. Even at our home, anything, the new cloth when we purchase, we will celebrate. We will say that it is my new dress. But once the moment you don't like, if something faded or it is damaged, you will be telling garbage, throw it away, throw it in the dustbin. So that is what your attitude would be. So similarly, in the programming language also, what we will be doing, the moment we want, we are allocating some memory portion for the variables or objects or for structure. We used to handle lot of data points during our programming or logical execution, whatsoever may be, especially data science. You imagine, without data, we are nothing to do with the data science. So we are in need of runtime memory. Always the concept of discussion, both at operating system and the compiler design, we are most bothered about runtime memory rather than the compile time memory. So the runtime memory management technique is called, one of the management technique is called garbage collection. What is the meaning of garbage? The moment we are requesting the computer or the memory management system to reserve memory for our objects or variables or for our references. The moment it is unused, it needs to be deallocated or need to be swept or need to be freed. The memory need to be freed. Otherwise, what will happen? You imagine the memory overflow will happen or memory, if you, especially the recent day trend of WeWork, we will open Google tabs and we will play music, we will do programming, we will parallelly work in Microsoft Word, we do multiple applications together. By the time the memory is memory insufficiency, that is a correct word, memory insufficiency, we would be facing fatal error. That is what I meant in the earlier class. Fatal error we would be facing. Memory insufficiency will lead to poor performance. You will be struggling. You cannot do whatever you wish to do at a time. At a time, we are trying to do some Microsoft Word application or C programming, or at a time we will be doing some Google Colab notebook, or we will be watching some video and we will be playing music as well. Something we will do mix and match in these recent days. Even professionally, if you work also, you are in need of multiple applications, multiple documentation work you will be doing. By the time memory inadequate issue will be erupted. In order to avoid that, always it is safe to have memory management technique. Every language, be it C language or the olden language or the latest language or the language going to be created, developed in near future, every language, this is one major component need to be considered. Like how we were telling, symbol table is one of the major component. Memory management unit is also one of the major component. That's it. So what is memory management now? Allocation of memory, deallocation of memory, when to allocate, when to deallocate, or when to free the memory. So question related to these all, any algorithm tries to answer, optimizes the memory utilization, minimizes the overhead, improves the efficiency of the memory. All such things are termed as memory management. First of all, underneath memory management, we have discussed about symbol table, one of the concept. Now, the opposite end, how we can free, how we can utilize the memory and reuse the memory portion for continuous applications or different applications or parallel programming or parallel processing. Such kind of notion is called garbage collection. Always we know garbage meant for unwanted thing. In our daily life also, anything will become garbage the moment you and me doesn't recover that. Similarly, in the programming language also, if the declared data or declared memory is not recovered further, that is treated as garbage. Then what the algorithm does internally, how it frees, when it freezes, why it freezes, these are all the discussion we are going to do right now. So this garbage collection or memory deallocation can be done manually or automatic. If it is automatic, there are several algorithms. Manual, there is no several algorithms. Only one user or given the privilege, the varying from language. But it is on the user's responsibility. You and me, while coding, we need to take care of memory allocation, memory deallocation. Whereas automatic method, automatic memory garbage collector, uses different algorithm in different languages. How that the compiler, designer, the developer, Gudo Wansum, how he thinks while he was developing Python, it is on his sole responsibility. What type of algorithm he uses, whether existing algorithm, or he is going for the hybrid algorithm, or he develops his own algorithm, depending upon that. But it is major component of compiler. First, understand memory management system is major component. Within that, garbage collector or memory deallocation mechanism is important for every compiler or in any language. Now let us go one by one. Why is memory management is important? If memory management is not properly done, memory leak. What is a memory leak is when the program is not deallocating dead objects, memory leak, memory will be not utilized further, just allocated. That allocated portion remains same until you shut down your memory, your system. Unless otherwise you shut down your system, that allocated memory will be filled. Then you cannot even play a song, you cannot even play a movie. Just for entertainment, if you try also, it is not possible. Because every memory is allocated. If it is not deallocated, what will happen? Just imagine. Anything which is allocated need to be deallocated. Next, memory corruption. What is the problem will happen? Memory management is not properly maintained. When the program tries to free the already freed memory. So, trying to free already freed memory, that is corruption. Already deleted, trying to attempt that empty location means that is corruption. These are all the possible issues will happen if memory management is not properly done, or that automatic algorithm. I said manual is olden language that quickly we will be completing in couple of minutes. This session is all about how we can implement automatic algorithm is what the point of discussion. When it becomes automated, what are all the possible problems we need to take care is, number one is memory leak. The moment it is allocated but not deallocated, some portion if it is happening also, that will be a problem. That is memory leak. Next, what is memory corruption? If the algorithm deletes first in the first sweep, what is sweep is, this garbage collector cannot be executed in the periodic manner, like setting the time every 20 minutes once you go and do garbage collector. You can't tell like that. Garbage collector, every minute anything happens, any such kind of program you are executing also, you may do project also, you may do very smallest program also, it is fine, well and good. Anything you do all along with your program compilation, garbage collection is also need to be taken care and it will be executed parallelly. In parallel, it will be executed. So this is what we may need to understand. Next, memory corruption, dangling pointers. What is the meaning of dangling pointer is, when the program is trying to access memory that was freed. For example, one of the variable may be the reference for another variable. This variable, the moment you delete, then this another variable is facing the problem, dangling pointer problem. So anything which is required for one of the variable or object's execution, it is already has been deleted. Without understanding the references, it has been deleted. So that is called dangling pointer. These three are the challenging points any of the automatic memory management system or garbage collection system need to take care. Now, manual memory management problems are common in code with manual memory management because user may be expertise, user may not be expertise. Whenever it is manual, fully manual, it is purely the proficiency or the efficiency of the program is depending upon the proficiency of the coder. If the coder doesn't know the core mechanism of how the machine is working, how the compiler is working, he will not be bothered about memory allocation strategy and deallocation strategy parallelly. Even I myself used to do, during my coding duration or graduation time, I used to go for allocation. Malloc I used to do, but never I will free the memory. So that is all the point need to be considered when it comes manual. Manual is good. There is no big complication. But what is the side effect? User who is trying to code, if she or he is not possessing the capability of understanding of memory management, he may not handle the memory appropriately. So that we cannot give this choice to the user's hand, manual approach. So that all the modern languages fed with automatic garbage collection or memory management system. So next, memory leaks will happen. What is memory leaks? It is allocated, never it is deallocated. Whether it is essential or doesn't recover, people will retain that. See, this is the danger. In C language, if you are using malloc, you means user, need to deallocate. There is a function called free function. We are in the position to use free function the moment we are exiting from the program or exiting from the routine. Most of us, we don't do. You recollect. When you are doing linked list programming also, you will be requesting, demanding memory for node creation. Whatever the memory you have requested, you will not use the free function. There is a danger in it because C is the language or C++ is the language purely of user-dependent memory management system or garbage collection system. We, the users, need to deallocate the memory. If you don't use free, you will be in the position to demand and request using CLOC, MLOC or realloc, but you will not free the memory. Those memories will be considered as under requirement. Operating system cannot sensitize. Operating system will not touch those memory portion for further utilization or further programming or further operations. That is called memory leak. Till date it exists. So next is memory corruption and buffer overflow. Sometimes because of this overflow will happen, memory corruption will happen, something you will delete unknowingly, that may be dependent on yet another memory. Those are all called memory corruption, memory overflow. These are all the, without understanding the core of the memory or the allocation system, we tend to use, then that will lead to memory corruption or memory overflow or memory leak. These are all the three problems definitely will be faced when the manual memory management system is followed. What is the meaning of memory freed? When the object is not used or when the object is not reachable. what is not reachable, variable may be declared but never used. That is one of the concept available in C. This will give gentle warning, never we will get error when it becomes C language. So what is memory not reachable? There are variable definitely cannot reach such way that user tend to write coding. That is deficiency in coding. He or she cannot write the code due to logical disconnect or delink or not understanding that concept, whatever may be. So that variable never ever it will be reached. The logic will not go to that portion at all. That is memory not reachable. There is another way also. You will be writing program if and else. Else part may be using different variables. If part may be using different variables. All the time when you are giving input, certain input to the program, that will follow only the if condition, let us imagine. Never ever it will follow the else condition. In such case also, memory not reachable problem will come. You imagine you are trying to do X into Y. Here you are trying to do A into B. If the value is of this, you wanted to do if portion, or else you want to do else portion. But whatever the input trial you are trying to give during the execution time, never ever that A and B will be reachable. These are all the problems we need to take care, or it is available, not reachable, consider. If you look at C and C++, recover pre-allocation, deallocation memory, similar to the dynamic memory allocation. Both in that C language or in the modern language, memory allocation only I mean to say here pre-allocation, deallocation is required. Example, these are all the language, C and C++ are the language, completely user management. It is completely under manual memory management or user memory management. User are the responsible, users are the responsible for this memory allocation and deallocation. When it comes C language, dynamic memory allocation, we used to do malloc, calloc, realloc. Similarly, we are supposed to use free function for the memory deallocation. You may ask one question now. I'll be declaring int A, comma B, comma C, comma D. That is called compile time memory allocation. That memory allocation, naturally, it is automatic. User don't have any control in any of the language. Please understand. I'm talking about only runtime memory allocation or execution time memory allocation only. Here only, again, two types. Manual memory management system or deallocation system or automatic. For automatic, you are having only one logic in your syllabus, that is reference counting or references counting. That is the only algorithm. That's it. We are going to complete this chapter, this particular given portion today itself. So now let us go for what we are doing. In the hope so you would be understanding. C is the only language you can imagine for fixed memory allocation or under the user memory management control, user memory management system. So user only need to manage the memory. Performance of automatic memory management is better than in the past. Nowadays, now we are slowly getting into automatic memory allocation. Recent days, performance of automatic memory management is better. Nowadays, automatic memory management system is becoming better and better. In which the classical example is, one of the classical example we can call it a Java also. Python is much more efficient than. Python's memory allocation, deallocation method is purely automatic. Why I appreciate than even Java and Python is, automation is becoming more. Java, even though Java does memory management automatically, users are expected to give the data type, declaration, requirement. You all pretty much very well with both Java and Python. When it comes to Python, you and me, no need to specify the data type. Automatically, it will take care. Dynamic memory management system is available. Not even automatic, please understand. Java has automatic memory management system. Python has dynamic memory management system, there is much more difference or much more features are added into Java, sorry, Python. Look at here. Users does not have to pre-allocate, deallocate memory similar to using dynamic memory allocation in language such as C and C++. Python uses two different strategies for the memory allocation. One is reference counting. Second one is garbage collection. Shortly, we are going to look at what is this reference counting, what is this garbage collection, nothing to worry. If you wish, you can watch this video. I appreciate this video because of good articulation. Also, lot of animations are illustrated in order to understand understand better of that concept. Prior to Python version 2.0, very first version, there is no such improvement. Python 2.0, Python interpreter uses a strategy called reference counting for memory management. Reference counting works by counting the number of times an object, what is this reference counting? I'll make understanding to you. See, for example, you are declaring b is equal to 1. First time, the reference count will be 1, because one time b is used, it can be 2 also, reference count will be 1. Next step, what I'm using is a is equal to b plus 10. Now the reference count for small b is small b is 2, because first time it is initialized, now second time it is used. Next, c is equal to b into 10. Now one more time the reference count is incremented. Reference of that variable is becoming more and more in the subsequent sequences of program. But if you look at the program, I'm printing C. That's all. Print C. I'm done. I'm doing print C. After that, I'm not at all referring B. Then what will happen? So reference count of these two became 2. After this no more reference count. Then the reference count naturally need to be decremented or need to be set as 0. Because after that, there is no more utilization of the variable B. After that, I may use different logic. I may do whatever I want. So that is called reference count. Simple terms, you can understand. This is more than sufficient. Let us discuss a little bit more in the complex programming context, like within function, multiple function, those contexts, how self-referencing context, how it is going to be used. Let us invest some time. When the references to an object are removed, reference count for an object is decremented. If there is no more reference to the object or removed, then the reference count of that object will be naturally decremented. Now let us understand this one more example. Literal 9 is an object. It is assigned to B. Reference count of object will become 1 here. Now, B is in Python, this is not in other language. Please understand, this is example in only this possible for Python. Now B is equal to 4. Now the reference count of the previous B would become 0, because B value is changed to 4. This B will become different. This reference will be completely deallocated. Newly, it will be created. The literal value is 9. The reference count of the object is 1, is incremented to 1. In the line, its reference count becomes 0. As it is dereferenced, because B is not either updated. Suppose if you update B also, it will be referencing the same point, but we are not referring. Rather, it is deallocated. It will become new B. The previous B will be deallocated. The garbage collector deallocates the object. There is one more beauty in Python. See, for example, if any one of you tries to give A is equal to 10, B is equal to 10. Now the question I will ask you. whether it will have two memory references or only one memory reference is the only question for you. Suppose A is equal to 10, B is equal to 5, that is a different scenario. Now A is equal to 10, B is equal to 10. What would be the reference? Same or different? Kindly put your answer either in audio or in the chat window, text form. For this scenario, whether the memory references are same or different, your answer is same or different or not same. In Python, I'm asking in Python. Guys, could you get my voice? For this situation, what is the memory reference for this scenario? Whether the memory reference for A and B are same or different? Are you there? No one is there. No one is attending the session. Good. D1 have given answer different. At least you have responded. That is well and good. I appreciate your active participation. It is not different. When the value becomes same, especially initial time, it will try to give the same memory reference for the same value. Since values are same, it will create one memory location. In that memory location, it will place 10. A and B both will point, try to point the same memory location. That is the I can't say it is beauty or disadvantage also. Python has this kind of memory allocation routine. If at all C language, what is your answer? This right. I agree for C language. Different is perfectly correct. So that is the reason I am breaking your mindset. You need to come out of that conventional thought. That is the reason I questioned this. When it comes Python, it is taking care of this variable or this memory object as a same memory reference. So only one memory reference is created, then it will start pointing the same. But immediately you are going to alter. Imagine next line you are going to alter. B is equal to A plus B. Or A plus 20. Something you are going to change for B. The moment you change, automatically one more memory reference is created. Complete dynamic, complete automatic. Automatic mechanism is invoked in Python language. Different memory reference, absolutely right for C language. But it is not true for Python language. Guys, could you able to get now what I'm going to say? So now immediately if I try to use B is equal to something, A into 25, something I'm using. Now the memory reference for A and become at this point, memory reference. This is example in Python. Next is memory reference become different here. Got the point? Memory reference becomes different. So this one scenario is enough for you to understand if you have some conflict of thought or some confusion. Now let us understand through an example. This snapshot I have taken from that video, so you can watch that video. Look at here in Python, x is equal to 10, type of the variable x is something, it says class int. Next, y is equal to x, this is another scenario. Like this scenario, A is equal to 10, B is equal to 10. How I have created, this is another scenario. Look at here, Y is equal to X. Now the question is whether both X and Y are different or same. Here also same. How this scenario I have created, the same scenario only here in this video articulated in Python. ID is the function. You can use it to understand the memory references, the information about memory address, I can say. So in C language, you will use ampersand symbol, no? It is equivalent to like that. In order to connect with that, more or less it is equivalent. So ID of X is equal to ID of Y. Print X, Y, refer to the same object. See, like this code, you can also write int A equal to 10, int B equal to 10. Here, if you write a code, you can try immediately soon after the class. If ID of A, we can confirm this, ID of A is equal to ID of B, then print same. Here, same code you can write, but not equal to, but definitely it is not equal to. You can write like this, else also, you can put else, otherwise print not equal. You will understand this concept much more authentically. You can execute and understand. Here you can write different. So how to understand this? ID, that's all. So you just go and write this piece of code in Google Colab or any of Python online IDE, or if you have installation, you can do. So ID of A, double quotation, double close. This is the only mistake I did. So you can write this piece of code that will make you to understand either this way or this way. X is equal to Y, this way. Now look at X is equal to X plus 1. Here what I did, similarly B is equal to A into 25. So that's all, X is equal to X plus 1. Now, different memory object. The moment we are trying to alter the value, it becomes two different memory objects. Z is equal to 10. Now, what we are trying to do, we are trying to allocate Z is equal to 10. Already, X is equal to 10. It will also go and refer the same memory. Please understand the beauty, see. When the value RHS becomes same, LHS also will point to the same memory location. So you look at ID of Y equal to ID of Z, it is same memory. Now Z is equal to car. Immediately we are changing. We are trying to give Z is equal to car, something we are function call invocation we are trying to give here. Immediately it becomes different. That's it. Class main underscore car, it refers type of that. So why it is referring this, why it is different memory? Because it is assigned with different memory location. That's all you may need to understand in Python language, dynamically typed language, because never ever we try to give the data type. Everything is object in Python. So here automatic memory location is highly essential, or that is the reason it is implemented. In C language, if you look at, we don't have this kind of object paradigm. When it becomes C++ also, yes, we do have normal variable, we do have object. It is mixed we have. But the memory management is purely manual. Nothing has been implemented in terms of automatic. Java, they started implementing automatic memory location. Then it becomes Python. Fully automatic or much more better, because everything used in Python is of object data type. Now let us understand further few of the concept. Almost the topic coverage has been done, but for the sake of your examination point of view, I'm just running through the material. Automatic allocation, deallocation variable on the stack memory is common. Stack memory, automatic allocation, deallocation is common. How the interrelationship stack memory and heap memory, I will show you right now. Look at here in this memory, in this piece of code, DI. I tried typing, I couldn't type, so I cropped from the Microsoft Word. So look at here, int save data for key, character key, file out. Something we are trying to declare, you try to imagine, that is more than enough. So this is a kind of body of the function. So you are trying to create a structure variable data item DI. How you can bring all of a sudden here? It should be global variable. The moment the function control exit from this, the moment it returns, it executes the return statement, data item DA will be deallocated. That is the information I am trying to convey right now. Nothing concept I am trying to tell. See, automatic allocation, deallocation, how it happens is, memory for DA is automatically allocated when the function executes and freed when it completes. So it will be freed automatically. That's all. Extremely simple and efficient memory management for languages like C and C++ that have complex value type. For any complex data types such such that structure, union, these are all termed as complex data type in C language. It takes care of allocation and deallocation like this, automatically they mean to say. But when it comes to dynamic memory allocation, malloc, calloc, realloc, you and me are the responsible person for freeing those memories. Otherwise, it will be allocated. Never it will be freed. It will be on the memory. It will be occupied. Now let us move on to the next concept. Memory allocation on the heap is allocated explicitly. Where you are permitted to allocate malloc? That question already stack memory, heap memory, two memory in the previous class also, symbol table handling. So when you are requesting for malloc, calloc, realloc, where those memory are allocated, that question should be there with you. Always automatic memory handling happens only with the stack memory. Users are not at all permitted to handle stack memory. Although you talk about stack data structure, the stack data structure is internally available with RAM or stack memory, but you and me are not at all permitted to allocate, deallocate with stack memory. You and me are intervened with heap memory. The moment you are trying to allocate or deallocate anything, you are working with, you are handling heap memory. That is another message I am conveying. You need to understand that. Automatic reclamation does not remove the need to manage object life cycles and does not prevent memory leaks. So automatic, when it comes, these all, what is the drawback they are trying to address? What is the drawback is, there are memory, never it will be freed. Memory leakage will happen. Self-reference time, it will create lot of issues. Memory allocation happens, self-referencing object, inter-referencing objects will create some issues. So without knowing that self-reference or automatic reference or cross-references, you may tend to free something or automatically, then further conflict will be raised. So these are all those notions we need to keep in our mind. Now automatic memory management or heap management, how it is trying to do? It start allocating any object is not longer used, automatically it will be allocated for the reuse. This is the first mantra it does. Look at here, this RAM memory, this scenario, it may help you to understand much more better. Stack memory, heap memory, anything which we declare the memory portion exactly to hold the data will happen with the heap memory. Stack memory will have all the references. Just it will have references. The moment main function is executed, look at here, main function y is equal to 5, z is equal to f1 of y. The function call invocation is happening. The call is transferred to f1. By that time, activation record is created for main. So this is what the activation record. That activation record is pushed onto the stack. What are all the objects referred or objects are declared in main? X and Y object. So Y is pointing to the heap memory location for the value 5. F1. From F1, x is one of the memory location, y is at another memory location. So x is referred with x into 2. So what is the value available in x? That value is going to be multiplied with 2. So this is how stack memory is utilized. When the control is transferred to F2, one more activation record is created. Similarly, the control from this F2, it will come back to F1. This memory will be freed. Control will come back from F1 to main function. This will be freed. The moment your program execution or completion, if you are closing the program, anything happens, then this main memory also will be freed. This is happening automatically. So the memory is allocated majorly. They are exhibiting with 3. One is this, one is this, one is this. They have mentioned other processors, application and shared memory. I mentioned there is one more memory you need to know down. That is instructional memory, and another one is data memory. The data memory only so far now we are discussing right now. So this is called data memory. Instructional memory, in your entire syllabus itself, there is no discussion happens. There is no more explanation. So, but you need to understand there is exclusive memory for instructional memory. Look at here. This is for self-reference. Main is the function, car of 4. Object initialization is happening. Car of 4. So now what is happening? Immediately the control will from main, it will go to init. INIT, init. The moment it goes here, self-reference will happen. Self, W. So what is the value W receives? That will go to self.wheels equal to W. So now get wheels. The moment it steps into get wheels, one more activation record is created for init. Get wheels of self, return self.wheels. So whatever is available here, it will return that. These all value will be referred cyclic. Self, car, wheel, W equal to 4, this is how Python starts referring. The next concept is reference counting. Simple automated heap management scheme, that's all. This is called heap management, the next memory portion we are discussing about. So far now, in the symbol table, most of the time, runtime memory management, we were discussing about stack memory. Now we are more about heap memory management. If you look at heap memory management, it will have the number of references. It will have based on the number of objects which is created, then incremented each time a reference to the object is created, decrement when a reference is destroyed. So whenever the usage or utilization is more for that object, it will be incremented. Reference point will be incremented. There is no use, then it is not referred, then it will be decremented. This is how it will have the value for deallocation. Reference count, the moment it becomes 0, the memory will be deallocated. Or the code is not reachable, or that object is not reachable, it will be deallocated. Two situation only. No more reference, or if that object is not reachable. For that object, if there is no more reference, if that object is not reachable. So two points you need to remember. So if you look at this kind of reference counting, widely used in Perl and Python, Mac OS, Objective-C. This is the language it uses. What is the limitation here? It cannot detect the cycles. Object referring to another object cannot be detected in this method. Next, garbage collection. This always referencing count can be avoided through tracing the algorithm. Internally, compiler design should, in order to avoid this, object referring to another object, then it cannot able to deduct the cycle we are trying to tell now. Then there must be algorithm for detecting such kind of cycles internally. Through that, it is possible to avoid. So if you look at here, see Java language uses mark sweep algorithm. each language uses different algorithm for memory management. That portion you should remember. Every language has its own memory management technique. One such technique available is this. These are all the algorithms or techniques majorly discussed in operating system, wherein which you can refer. So generational algorithm is also one. More compact algorithm, copying algorithm. These are all the popular or widely used algorithms for automatic garbage collection technique available. So these four. When it comes to Java, mark sweep algorithm is used. Just for your reference, I'm just giving one of the scenario. Data type declaration in Python not required. Java typed language. This is called statistically typed language. What is 10? This 10, an object created on heap memory. This object is created on heap memory. Here, a primitive data stored in 4 byte or 2 byte. Here there is no 2 byte or 3 byte. It is created a memory portion in heap memory. Here it is treated as a primitive data type. 4 byte for Java, 2 byte for C. It will start consuming when it comes Java language or C language. Memory allocation is purely dependent upon the data type and underlying language implementation for that platform. Whereas Python, we no need to worry because objects are created on the heap memory. There is a certain notion. If you wish, you can further refer. That's all. This all for your knowledge point of view I have brought. There are two references, one video, one article I have given here. With that, you can further learn and can explore a lot on this topic. We will be moving on to the optimization technique in the next session.